on to Tampa, Florida, home of the 1995 WWF Royal Rumble Spectacular. You are looking at a live picture of the Sun Dome here in Tampa. Folks, we are totally live for the Action Zone. My name is Todd Pettengill, along with Gorilla Monsoon and Jim Ross. I'll be bringing you the live drawing for the selection of the WWF Royal Rumble match. What an hour we've got lined up for you here, live on the Zone. The important stuff, as you can see, I'm back at me, WWF officials getting ready to begin the drawing that will determine the order of appearance for the WWF superstars in the actual Royal Rumble matchup. We will be covering it all day and bring you updates of superstars as they make their selection. Plus, when we come back, a live interview with Big Daddy Cool Diesel and the Hitman Bret Hart on the Action Zone. Welcome back, everyone, to the Sunshine State, Tampa Bay, Florida, 1995 WWF Royal Rumble Spectacular. Got the shades working and the action happening tonight. Action Zone totally live from Tampa Bay. Now, here's the deal, folks. Tonight at 7 o'clock Eastern, 4 Pacific, you can check out the WWF Royal Rumble Spectacular totally live on pay-per-view. You're watching cable now. Just call your local cable company. Their number's right on your last cable bill and order the WWF Royal Rumble Spectacular. It's that easy. Now, remember, this is the World Wrestling Federation, the originator, not the imitator, so you know absolutely anything can happen and usually does at WWF pay-per-view events. Let's get right into it and talk about the WWF Championship on the line tonight in Tampa as Big Daddy Cool Diesel squares off with the Hitman Bret Hart. You want to talk about an incredible matchup? Here you have two of the most popular superstars in the World Wrestling Federation. Power against speed. It's the matchup of the century. We're lucky enough to have both competitors standing by in their respective dressing rooms right now. Diesel, Big Daddy Cool, let me begin with you. Obviously, you have to be excited about this match and a little bit nervous as well. How are you going about preparing for tonight's matchup?
Well, you know, Todd, it's 7 hours away, so I'm just reading some good literature here. And I'm kicking back. I've got the caterers, gave them a call earlier, so my homeboys would make sure they were fed today when they come in, and, you know, just kicking back.
You're reading the funnies?
A little high and lowest.
It's nice to see, Todd, that the Big D is so relaxed. You know, that's exactly how I like to prepare for a big match. I like to mellow out. I like to put everything out of my head. You know, I'm just gonna, it's sort of like the calm before the storm, right? Isn't that kind of what it is here, calm before the storm?
You guys got to be ribbing a little bit. Obviously, you're a little bit nervous about this.
I'm not ribbing. I mean, I seriously think that it's the best way to prepare for a fight. Go ahead, read the funnies. I hope you can read them after the match, Big D. I hope you can read them after the match.
It's funny, you know, I got an advanced copy of the new World Wrestling Federation magazine. Oh, yeah? You're on the cover there, Bret. Spend a little time acting, huh? Are you thinking about a career change?
No, not really. Hey, it's a good cover.
Man.
That's a good cover.
Hitman,
nice shot.
Let me just ask you.
I want to put that on your ceiling.
Bret, let me ask you about the jackknife. You and I have talked about it before. You said it's an awesome maneuver. You're thinking about that. It has to be weighing heavy on your mind tonight.
Well, let me put it this way. The jackknife is comparable to maybe, say, perhaps falling out of a 20-story building. It's not something you look forward to. I'd say the way I look at the jackknife is I will be avoiding it at all costs. That's the big question, is can he get the jackknife on? You know, that's the big question. I don't think so. I think the sharpshooter, for example, has got to be weighing on Diesel's mind much more than the jackknife is on mine.
Diesel, how about the sharpshooter?
I'm not going to sit here and say Bret's not a great wrestler, because he is, and the sharpshooter is a devastating hold. It's a great finisher, but like he's saying, you got to get it on me, Bret, and I'm not going to be laying around tonight.
Well, the thing about it, these, all due respect, I keep dreaming and envisioning these long legs. I mean, that's all I keep seeing is these big long legs, and it's
thinking of Susan Anton or what? What's the deal with that?
Gentlemen, obviously you're both loose and confident. Good luck to both of you tonight in the championship matchup.
Two kinds of luck.
Thank you, Todd.
Thank you very much for talking with us. Obviously, folks, all these guys are rested, ready. A little bit cocky, too. We'll find out what happens tonight when they square off. Also, WWF Intercontinental title will also be on the line as the bad guy, Razor Ramon, squares off against Music City's Double J, Jeff Jarrett, with the roadie in his corner. Now, obviously, the bad guy, two-time Intercontinental champion, does anything he has to win. What role will the roadie play in tonight's matchup? We will find out. Intercontinental Championship on the line. You will also see The Undertaker squaring off with the Taxman. The ultimate showdown in Tampa, Florida, as death meets taxes. What role will the Druids play in this? Well, we'll find out. We're going to talk to The Undertaker a little bit later on here on the Action Zone. We'll give you an update. Now, let's talk about my favorite matchup of the entire year, the actual WWF Royal Rumble match. It's incredible. Let me quickly run down the rules for you. Here's how it works. Superstars will be entering the squared circle every 60 seconds. The only way you're eliminated is when you get thrown over the top rope and your feet touch the floor. The last superstar in the ring is declared the winner and gets a title shot at WrestleMania 11. Imagine that, 30 WWF superstars in the ring at the same time. The only way you're out is when you go over the top rope, both feet touch the floor. It should be absolutely incredible. Lots of people talking about King Kong, Bundy, Mabel, size, a big differential in this one. You can see it totally live tonight by calling pay-per-view. That's all you have to do. Call your local cable company and tell them you want your WWF, the Royal Rumble, totally live from Tampa Bay, Florida. The sold-out Sun Dome is going to be rocking, folks. And speaking of rocking, the action continues here. Duke the Dumpster Drossy is coming up next. Stay with us.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
All right, guys, here's the deal. Selection process, as you mentioned, underway right now. WWF superstars prohibited from discussing their selection. What they're doing right now is selecting the number, determining their order of appearance for tonight's WWF Royal Rumble matchup. Bob Backlund is making his selection now. Maybe we can jump in. He's discussing his selection with President Jack Tunney. Mr. Backlund, could I just get your reaction to your selection here?
It's all irrelevant. The supreme excellence in warfare is the destruction of your enemy's desire to put out an effort. And I have succeeded in that. I've convinced the whole world, including you, that I will reign supreme in the Royal Rumble. You got that? I don't like that tie either.
Bob Backlund, happy or unhappy with his number? We won't know. Coming up next, an odds-on favorite to win the whole thing. King Kong Bundy. Well, gentlemen, as you said, the selection process continuing all day today. We'll be covering the Heartbreak Kid. Shawn Michaels now making his selection. Now, remember, superstars are not allowed to discuss the number that they pick. However, we can tell somewhat from their response. As Shawn Michaels picks his number now, the Heartbreak Kid seems to be... Shawn, we see the number...
Well, the fact of the matter is, the Heartbreak Kid picked yellow because he is mellow yellow today. I got news for you, Todd. The Heartbreak Kid has had some easy nights in the past, but usually that involved 29 other women. But today, it involves 29 of the biggest, baddest World Wrestling Federation superstars. But still, nonetheless, tonight is going to be an easy night for the old HB Kid.
Obviously happy with his selection, the Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels. Congratulations. We'll see you in action out there tonight.
Oh, you're going to see a little more than action from the Heartbreak Kid. You're looking at the winner of the 1995 Royal Rumble.
Welcome back, everyone, to sunny Tampa, Florida. Look at the palm trees, the sun poking through. Oh, this is a great day. The selection process continues here with the Smoking Guns, Billy and Bart. Billy has already picked. Guys, excuse me for just a second. This has got to be a dual interest night for you guys, because coming up tomorrow night on Monday Night Raw, you guys will face the new tag team champions. But right now, order of appearance for the actual Royal Rumble match. Billy's already made his selection. He's smiling.
What do you mean? Tell me his number.
All right, Bart, make your selection.
Go ahead, you pick.
All right.
And then you show me.
Oh, I'm going to show you, okay. Let's see what we got.
Order of appearance for the actual Royal Rumble match.
Okay.
And Bart looks happy as well.
No, you said every man for himself.
Exactly.
That's exactly right.
So let me see your number.
No.
I'll show you mine.
That's exactly what it is, folks. No partners, no nothing. Every man for himself. Let's take you back to ringside right now. Welcome back, folks, to the Live Action Zone here in Tampa, Florida. Folks walking the beach now, but tonight they will be at the sold-out Sun Dome here in Tampa, Florida. Folks, I'm standing with the British Bulldog, Davey Boy Smith, who made his selection during the commercial break and was nice enough to stay with us through the break and talk about it. Bulldog, I can't help but notice you're a little bit disappointed.
Yeah, I'm really disappointed, Todd.
but it also could have been a lot better. But the British Bulldog has come prepared today for the Royal Rumble, and I'm willing and able to come the Royal Rumble champion.
All right, British Bulldog, you heard it from his mouth, guys. Not very happy, but nonetheless, he's ready. Let's go back to you.